Hey everyone, my name is Kajal and welcome to another Webots tutorial. For today's Webots tutorial, we are implementing Braitenberg vehicles. In this video, I'll talk about what are Braitenberg's vehicle and then we'll implement the same in Webots. I've also included the timings in the description below. So without further ado, let's get into it. Braitenberg vehicle is a simple concept that an agent-like robot can drive with respect to the sensor input. You can directly connect motors to sensors and get interesting behaviors. A sensor is represented with this symbol and a motor is a rectangle. The connection between a sensor and motor is shown by dotted lines and the entire vehicle is enclosed with another rectangle. The simplest vehicle is one sensor connected to one motor. It can simply drive proportional to the input received at the sensor. The sensory input or stimuli can be a light source, temperature, or even sound. By proportional, I mean more light will lead to higher speed and less light will lead to lower speed. The vehicle gets more complicated with a set of two sensors and two wheels. With a set of two sensors and motors, the sensor that receives more light will drive the motor faster than the other one. Before we head to Webot, let's talk about one more concept, the inverse. Instead of proportionally increasing speed with respect to light, this will have decreasing speed. What do you think the type of behavior will be exhibited by our vehicle or robot? Similarly, you can also connect one sensor to the opposite motor and the second sensor to the first motor. Let's try all of this in Webot and see what the behavior looks like. Let me start with a new project. So on the menu bar, go to Wizard, New Project Directory, click Continue and name your project. I'm going with Braitenberg Vehicle Project. You can even name your world. Make sure to add a rectangular arena and click Continue. Click Done. With this, we're starting with an empty world. Let's try the second type of model with two sets of wheels and two motors. For this demo, I'm using a four-wheeled robot. However, we'll treat the left two wheels as one set and the right two wheels as a second set. You can choose to build your own robot or simply use the one that I have already pre-built. I'll include the link to download this in the description below. This was one of my first robots in Webot that I created using the Webots documentation. Simply go to the link to download the four-wheeled robot Proto. Make sure to click on Raw and copy the link. Next, open a terminal window. Navigate to the Proto folder in your Webots project folder. Then use the wget command to download this file. As we can see here, the file was downloaded. If this doesn't work for you, you can simply go back to the link, go to the main folder called YouTube Tutorial Download Material and download the zip file. This will download all the files. So you will have to navigate inside Braitenberg Vehicles, copy this file from your downloads folder to the Webots project folder. Now when we come back to Webots, click on the plus sign and under Proto Nodes current project, you should be able to see the four-wheeled robot. Click Add and this will add the robot to our Webots world. As you can see, this has gone inside, so I'm just gonna move it up. We'll do this by changing the translation value of Y to 0.04 meter. Make sure to save your work. Now, as mentioned before, we need to add sensors. In general, in Webots, when you have a proto file, you can convert it back to base node to be able to make changes. For this, go to the Webots scene tree, select the proto node, right click and click on convert to base nodes. As you can see, we now have access to the entire robot. Under children, you can see body shape, which is the rectangle in red color and the four wheels. So our next step is to add sensors. Under robot, under children, click the plus sign to add another node. Under base node, click on light sensor. For our scenario, we're going to use light as a stimulus and thus we need a light sensor to detect that light. Click on add. Make sure to keep saving your work. Now you probably can't see the light sensor. So to make it visible, let's give it a shape. Under light sensor, under children, click on the plus sign. Under base node, select shape and click add. Under shape, you can change appearance and add geometry. Let's start by adding geometry. Once again, you can use the plus sign or simply double click. Under base node, select box and click add. Now as you can see, it created this big box. Before changing the size, let's add appearance. Click on appearance and then double click, or you can use the plus sign. Under base node, select PBR appearance and click add. Under appearance, you can change the color. Let's make it blue. Change roughness to 1 and metalness to 0. Coming back to the box, let's change the shape. Instead of 0.1 meter, let's make it 0.01 meter. Now again, you're not able to see this because any new node added in Webot is added at 0, 0. In other words, your light sensor with the shape of a box is inside the red box and thus you're not able to see it. So we're simply going to move it. Under light sensor, go to translation. To make it a little easier, let's enable coordinate system. On the top menu, go to view, optional rendering, and click on show coordinate system. As you can see here, we now have an idea of X, Y, and Z. We want to bring this to the front of our robot. So we have to move it in the Z direction. Let's make Z as 0.1 meter. Let me explain why I made Z equal to 0.1. So if you go to the body shape box, which is our red rectangle, you can see the Z is 0.2 meters. As I said, everything is at 0, 0. So to bring it forward, I'd have to change it by 0.1. To bring it either to the right or left direction, I'm going to change the X direction. Let's go back to our light sensor and make X equal to 0.03. Now you should be able to see the blue box, which represents our sensor, but we don't know which direction our sensor is pointing to. To make this a little easier, let me show you another trick. On the top menu bar, click on View, Optional Rendering, and click on Show Light Sensor Rays. This we are able to see the rays. We want this to be pointing forward. So let's go to Rotation, and to get it to point forward, we'll rotate it along the Y direction. You should be able to see another arrow telling you about the direction of rotation. So to move it in the forward direction, we'll have to move it in the negative direction by 90 degrees. This is in radians, which will make it minus 1.57 radians. And as you can see, it's now pointing forward. Make sure to save your work. Now to make it easy for us to access the light sensor from our code, let's change the name. Default is light sensor. Let's make it ls underscore left. Another important point to look is the lookup table. The lookup table tells us how the sensor readings will be received. Each row represents a point. So for the first one, if it detects anything at 0 meters, it will give us a reading of 0. And the last value in the row represents noise. Right now we have 0 noise. The second one tells us anything detected at 1 meter will give us a reading of 1000. So essentially all the readings between 0 to 1 meter will be available as reading between 0 to 1000. You can always change this to make what you want. For example, you can make it so that it gives you a reading of 0 to 10. For now, let's keep it at 0 to 1000. Now let's add the second sensor. Instead of making it from scratch, simply copy and paste it, and we'll make the necessary changes. The first one being the name. Let's change it to ls underscore right and click enter. Next, we want to move it on the other side of the robot. So we'll change x to minus 0.03. And as you can see, it's also pointing forward. Make sure to save your work. Now the next thing we need is a stimulus, which is going to be a light. So let's add some light. Before that, let's make our arena a little bigger. So click on rectangular arena, click on the arrow on the left side, and then select floor size. Let's make it an arena of 5 by 5 meters. Next, let's add the light source. Click on the plus sign. Under base node, select point light and click add. You should be able to see this reflection and see a difference in the lighting. Under point light, with location, you are able to change the location of where this point light is placed. Let's bring it to the floor. As you can see, now it's under the robot. Let's bring it ahead of the robot. So I'm going to change Z as 0.5 meters. As you can see, our light source is here now. Make sure to save your work. With the current setup, we actually have two light sources. One is the point light and the second is the ambient light. You can go about this in two ways. One is to disable the ambient light and only have the point light. Or second, have the ambient light, but whenever you get the light sensor readings, you'll have to normalize it to be able to detect the point light. For now, let's just remove the background light, which is the ambient light. Simply click on the textured background light, right click and delete. As you can see, the ambient or background light is completely gone and now there's only one light guiding our robot. Make sure to save your work. Next, we'll write code in Python to connect our sensors and motors. All of this will be covered in the next tutorial and I'll add the link once it's published. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like. If you have any questions, ask them in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer them. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.